So here we go. Subnetting a network into smaller networks. So setting up a realistic problem in order to learn subnetting is actually kind of a challenge because we don't do subnetting like this in the real world right away. Well, let's say this. We don't do subnetting like this in the real world, and the reason we don't is because it's much like learning the alphabet and learning how to spell and speak and write. We have to learn our letters first before we can learn how to spell, before we can learn how to write. So we have to have some basis to get started so that we can then use that and transform it into all these different words and whatnot. And subnetting kind of works the same way. We have to start teaching you the mathematics and the theory behind it and the basics of it so that you can understand how to apply it in a much broader sense. So we start with these problems that are relatively unrealistic, and then we move into problems that are much more realistic. And what ends up happening is, as you move through these problems, you begin to get a really good understanding of the addressing and how it's worked and how it's broken up, and you can do some magical things with those addresses then, and subnetting. So what we've done here is our internet service provider. So we're a large size company, medium size company maybe. And our internet service provider here is going to provide us a range of address. And the range of addresses are 203.0.113.0/24. And we can do whatever we want with that IP space that we like, as long as we keep the network portion the same. Now, in our particular environment, we have 8 facilities scattered throughout a geographical area. So these 8 different facilities each need their own network address assigned to it. Since our ISP only gave us one network address, we need to break that up into 8 network addresses. So let's take a look at how we do that. The first thing we want to do is we want to examine the range of addresses that our internet service provider gave us. And the range of addresses that it gave us are going to go from the network address 203.0.113.0 all the way up to the broadcast address 203.0.113.255. If I convert that to binary, you see here I have my network address up on top with the first 24 bits of the address in the network portion. And then since it's a network address, I have all zeros in the host portion. For my broadcast address, I have once again the same network portion as my network address, but this time I have all ones in the host portion. And what this tells me, it means that I have 8 bits of the address to do anything I want with. So I can modify those 8 bits in a way to make it so that I can create 8 more networks. Let's take a look at how we do that.